Welcome to PHATT Audio Concepts in Brayside. My name's Sam Pansino. So let's take a look inside and see some of the crazy cars we get to work on. What it is we do here is modify any type of vehicle, whether it's a old American classic, an old Aussie classic, Japanese sports cars, Australian Commodores, Falcons, you name it, we do it all. Okay, here we have an XF Falcon. You can see we've got a couple of 15-inch subwoofers going either side. There's four clarion amplifiers to feed the whole audio system. There's three pairs of splits in the car, two in the front doors, one in the rear doors. The parcel shelf has just got a big vent in the middle, so as the bass hits, it can actually be vented into the cabin space. Yeah, we have a monitor in the rear console, one in each headrest, and also in the dashboard as well, in the center. And it's had custom door trims made front and rear. And they've actually been done with what we call flocking, which is similar to spray-on velour. The stuff is absolutely awesome, comes in any colour you like, and yeah, the wear on it is incredible. It just makes the car look 100% factory. It's almost like the speakers were meant to be there at a factory. They're trying to walk away from us now. So here we've got Marco's car. We're basically doing, yeah, full respray on it. We're going to try something a bit different. He's got the balls to try it. We're going to do matte black with a red pinstripe going through it somehow, just to suit the mag wheels as well. And then the whole car will be blocked back, and it'll be over to Vito to do his magic. So one of the best spray painters you'll ever come across, and later on in the series you'll see some of the cars he does, and I guarantee your jaw will just hit the ground. His work is almost as good as mine. Okay, better. Yeah, next up we have Quick WRX. Gentleman's had this car almost from new and loves it with a passion. Unfortunately, he got hit by a truck just recently, which broke his little spoiler. So he's now decided to buy the full big STI spoiler, which you'll see at the back. But like everything that's aftermarket, it never fits properly. Our job is to make it look like it's meant to be there. He's also bought the more aggressive STI bonnet scoop, which, like the spoiler, didn't fit properly. Our job, make it fit properly. So because we have all fiberglass facilities here as well, we can make these things look like they're meant to be there. Okay, you can see the dents on the back of the boot lid where the truck's managed to just give it a little bit of a nudge, but broke the spoiler in the process. And on the floor here, we have the big spoiler going on. It was two pieces, but we've blasted into one piece just to get rid of all the lines. We're going to make it really nice and neat. We've masked up the boot so when we put the spoiler on, we can bog up the lines and fiberglass up the lines, make them flush up to the boot lid 100%. So yeah, when you look at this car, you're just going to think that spoiler came with the car. Okay, if you can see me all the way on the other side of this big boat, we have a 59 Caddy. We're doing a full bare metal resto on it. We've just managed to strip it down and we're about to start doing the paint stripping side of things. This car's in incredibly good nick for its age. It did have a few little rust holes on the floor, but they've all been fixed up. We're now about to start attacking the body. The car will be turned into a wedding car, and we're just waiting to see. He wants some form of pink on his car. So as we get closer to the finished result, we'll see what we end up with. It should be pretty interesting. And hopefully he puts some really crazy wheels, because these look awesome with 20s or 22s. Or he might go for the just keeping the hubcaps on there. We'll just wait and see what he chooses. Okay, next up we have a supercar, a Maserati. Someone actually came to us with the balls to say, what most people do to their Falcons and Commodores, I want to do to my Maserati. At the moment, we're just calling this car Project A, and closer towards the finished result, you'll see why. Once again, full bare metal resto. This thing has to have the straightest lines you've ever seen on a car. The amount of work that's going into even just making the tail lights fit, instead of having the rubber seal that goes around the tail lights, they've been closed down so that way the metal itself buds up to the tail lens 100% perfectly. And yeah, we're just about to start attacking the interior. The vehicle is soda blasted to get rid of all the old paint. And yeah, we're still waiting for the owner to choose a color. We have an idea, and hopefully it's gonna be awesome. Yeah, we have the new BBS wheels that are gonna go into the vehicle as well. As you can see, they are monstrous. So they'll be replacing the original stock ones that were on there. The vehicle's getting a facelift as well. It was a 2001. We're going for the, I think it's a 2006 body kit. It has a more aggressive side skirt, more aggressive front bar and bonnet, and the rear bar, it's to die for. So when you see this thing finished, Okay, what we have here is actually one of my favourite cars, just as in from a modified point of view, even from a factory point of view. If you look under the bonnet, there is a big factory supercharger under there from TRD, the Toyota Racing Development. The vehicle came to us just for a minor stereo upgrade, but like most of us, he gets bitten by the bug and it just upgraded and upgraded. Now we've ended up putting two pairs of splits in the front doors from Boston Acoustic. They're the SPZ series, the sixes. So with two mids in the doors and two tweeters up on top of the dash, this car's gonna have a very, very strong presence in the front. The rear speakers, like all our other sedans, we have pulled out of the car for good. They'll be going into his girlfriend's car. And we have two big 12-inch subwoofers to come through the boot into the cabin space to rock your socks off, literally. Okay, here we've got an XY Falcon. The gentleman's doing it up as a semi-show car slash drag car. It's had a bare metal resto. And we've just waited for the customer to come in so he can tell us exactly what colour he wants to do. And this is ready for its first coat of paint shortly. Okay, this almost brings us to the end of our first episode. In about 2 weeks' time, we'll be heading up to Lunar Drive-Ins in Dandenong for a Fast and the Furious cruise, where we'll have the latest Alpine Dodge Nitro demo car that we just finished building. We're taking it out there for the night. We're going to have a lot of old American cars. We're going to have a lot of old Aussie muscle cars, and of course, a lot of Jap cars and Euro cars. So it's going to be our own little Fast and the Furious theme. We will have a lot of footage from there, so stay tuned. My name's Sam Pansino, and I thank you for watching.